What's good, Blast Up Podcast? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Jared. And y'all, we gonna do a video on Kendrick G's show again. And the kooky people keep coming out. Now, this is a single mom of three. She's divorced and she has two non-negotiables for her next man. Now, let's see what this bullshit gonna be. Because I can guarantee you, it's probably gonna be some shit. Let's get started.
You ready? Hello?
Hey.
Hey.
How are you?
Good. What your name is Danielle?
My name is Danielle, yes.
Danielle, where are you calling me from, boo?
I'm in Houston, Texas.
Houston. How old are you?
I'm 43.
43? Okay, you're looking for 43. What you do for a living, boo?
I work in corporate compliance and financial services.
Corporate compliance. You have any children?
I do. I have three kids. I have a 25-year-old, a 16-year-old, and a 13-year-old.
Okay. All by the same man?
So no, my oldest, I had her when I was 17. I was young and dumb. And then my other two are by my ex-husband.
Okay. When did you get divorced?
2013, October.
Oh, you remember, child. What's your zodiac sign? What's your zodiac sign, Danielle?
Sagittarius.
All right. So we got Danielle Houston, 43, Sagittarius. You said corporate compliance and finance?
Financial services, yes. I work for a large bank.
Say again?
I work for a large bank.
Okay. Mine are three kids by two men. Two of her children are by her ex-husband. She is now divorced. You only been married one time?
Yes.
Okay. What kind of man are you looking for, girl?
You know what? I'm so flexible. I don't really have, like, people come up with all these shenanigans with all these deal breakers. I don't have a lot of deal breakers. I have two. I need him to be Christian and, like, follow his Christianity walk. And he can't want to have more children. I don't want any more. I'm not having any more children.
Okay, so the main question is, what are you going to be offering? Because obviously, you have three children by two different men. You are a divorcee, and you make decent money. Okay. Cool. If he's not going to be having any children with you, you're looking for a stepfather for your children. So in a sense, you're not really offering anything to the table. I mean, I'm sorry to say it, but you're not.
That's it.
He can have kids, though.
He can have kids, absolutely.
Okay, so he be a Christian and don't desire for you to have any more children.
Correct.
That's all that you require.
That's not all that I require, but those are my two deal breakers.
Okay, non-negotiables, you mean?
My non-negotiables, yes.
Fair enough. Okay, so now, what kind of man are you looking for?
I don't have a preference in the looks category. I'm open. I've been engaged to someone who's 5'7". I've been married to someone who's 6'3", so I don't really have a height requirement. I don't have an ethnicity requirement. As far as income, because that's the big debatable thing, right? I don't have a deal breaker when it comes to income. However, you have to be able to support yourself. I don't want to support you. I don't want to have to help you. I don't want to support you. I'm not doing any of those things.
And that's understandable. A man should be able to hold his own. But I'm looking at it like this. If, let's say, for instance, you find a man that's, let's say, he's making $85,000 a year, which is exceptional money. He's making 85 grand a year. And he has children, but he wants to have a wife. He wants to get married and have a wife to have his children. You've already cut off the possibility of having children with you, so you're not going to have. You've already made it plain and clear that you're not wanting any children. Okay, cool. He's probably going to go get a woman that's younger than you and that's more available. Why is it that after y'all have these demand that y'all have these demands, which I understand is what you want, but you are bringing nothing to the table, and you said that he can have kids, he just don't have to want, he just not have to want kids, which is understandable. But we're still not getting why he would choose you. That's all I'm saying.
So there's really not a requirement. It depends on your lifestyle, right? Like, people can manage their lifestyle on different budgets. I have three children. I make a certain amount of income. So someone maybe who doesn't have children, maybe they don't need to make as much as I do. And that's fine. As long as you come to me completely whole and you can support yourself, I am okay with that.
Okay. What are your deal breakers?
Well, no, those are the only two deal breakers that I had. The ones that I mentioned is that he has to be Christian and that he can't want to have additional children.
Okay.
I mean, of course, he can't be alive. But to me, let me say this, though. When I say that he's Christian, that means he's walking his walk. So he shouldn't be a liar. You shouldn't be a cheater. You know, all of those things that would naturally you would expect. I'm honestly, Kendra, like, honestly, I'm open. I have tried so many things. And I've met a lot of great men. But the main thing is, they're not Christian, and that's just.
So are you? Hold on. Are you a Christian woman? No. Bring your ass back here. No. We gonna start cooking tonight. No. Are you a Christian woman? Because you want to sit here and say you want a Christian man. Are you a Christian woman? Because a Christian woman would still be married to her husband. A Christian woman wouldn't have had a kid outside of wedlock. A Christian woman would be still with her husband and being fruitful and multiplying. It's funny how y'all like to nitpick at little things like he has to be a Christian man and he has to walk in his faith. Okay, I'm a Christian man. I'm a Christian man. I'm walking in my faith. I don't have any kids outside of wedlock. I'm keeping my dignity to only one person. But here's the thing. I still don't have any kids by anybody outside of wedlock, and I am 25 years old. You have one at 17, and now you're talking about I was young and dumb. No, you were young and dumb, and you got pregnant, and now you want to sit here and act like you this holier-than-thou woman when you are not. We need to stop allowing these hoes to doggo act like they Christians after they fucked up their life. We need to stop it because this shit's getting out of fucking control with this shit. You got hoes in the doggone church talking about I'm a Christian woman. You got hoes on OnlyFans talking about I'm a Christian woman and I'm a boss bee, I'm a boss chick, and I'm all this bullshit. No, stop. I'm gonna need you to stop. Hell no. You bras need to stop lying.
Dating from sex?
Oh, let me be. I'm be honest, okay? So yes, I am currently, but
bullshit. No, hell no. No. I let that shit slide. No, bring your ass back here.
They're not Christian. And that's just.
So are you abstaining from sex?
Oh, let me be honest.
You ain't even abstaining from sex. You said, oof. That instant that, oof. That's the bullshit of, oh, let me try to make up a lie. I'm doing it for right now. For 5 minutes, but I ain't done it in the last 30, 40 years of my goddamn life. You need to, bitch, you ought to be ashamed of your damn self calling yourself a Christian. Ought to be ashamed of your damn self.
I'm be honest, okay? So yes, I am currently, but I've heard you ask a couple people if they've had sex. The last time I had sex was November of last year.
And why that man a damn choice?
I'm gonna go ahead and put that out there.
So
and
you
I'm
just
not
started to say, what? So you just started abstaining from sex in November?
Yeah, I have several other times.
The fucking line. See, This is the reason why I be cooking y'all asses. Y'all talking about, oh, I want a good Christian man walking in his faith. Bitch, you ain't even abstinent from sex. We all ain't being Christians, really, if you want to be completely honest. Men have needs and women have their needs. But the problem is, y'all gonna stop trying to lie and say y'all doing all this shit because y'all want to sit here and be holy in the thou. You ain't holy in the thou and you still out there fucking. So what are you talking about? You're looking for a man that walks in his faith. A man that walks in his faith is going to exercise strict no fucking policy.
I'm not perfect, and I'm not asking for him to be perfect.
Oh, you know what? Her and this dumbass look get on my fucking nerves.
Okay. Well, here's the thing.
That funky ass
and
laugh.
Respectfully so. I always bring this up because one thing you are driving home is he must be a Christian man. He must be a Christian man. Yeah. I know that's the number one thing Christianity preaches, which is no sex before marriage. So that doesn't matter too much to you.
It also is it's also practiced in the Muslim community. It's also practiced in the Jewish community. It's also practiced in Buddhist community. It's practiced all over the world. In fact, no fucking before marriage. But the problem is, we as humans have our needs, and we all break that sacred rule, especially everybody. So y'all need to stop with this whole lie talking about, oh, I'm a Christian and I'm trying to keep from having sex, so I'm having this 90-day rule after having 3 kids. Nigga, please, fuck out of here.
That's what there's a lot of things that are preached in Christianity, but I am not a perfect person and I'm not asking.
Okay, so but here's the deal. You're telling us, because we got to be clear, you're telling us he must walk as a Christian. That is a deal breaker to you if he's not walking as a Christian. So what qualities to you represent a man walking in his Christianity?
Well, so we all have our flaws. Like we all have sin. I'm not saying.
Baby mama's trying to give non-negotiables. That is the funniest shit I've ever heard. A baby mama trying to give non-negotiables and talking about walking from his Christianity when she herself hasn't even been practicing her Christianity her whole life. Yet she now want to come with some fucking sense. Yeah, okay. You, if you was a real Christian like you say you are, you would have still been married.
Saying you cannot be, you need to work towards not sinning. That's the point. But can I have a conversation with you about the Bible? Can we read it together? Can we pray together? Those are the things, because we're trying to get better together, right? So I'm not expecting him to be perfect. That's impossible. What I am expecting is, can I have an intelligent conversation with you about the Bible? Can we pray together so that we can get, you know, better together? Those are the things that I mean.
Well, the only reason I'm deep diving is because, I mean, I was about to move on and you said it very clear that you will not date a man who's not walking as a Christian man. That's why I asked, is this about, you know, sex? Because that's the most popular thing I think of when women say that. But now you said, so now are you abstaining from sex until marriage? Is that your goal? Well,
now I'm abstaining from sex. I'm going to say that. Like, I mean, I've gone like this. I'm just like any other person in the world, right? Like, I've gone like this. I'm not saying that for me, would I like to prefer to wait until I'm married again? Absolutely. I've gone 3 years, 3 times. Have I completed that journey? No. So I don't want to be a liar and just be like, oh yeah, I'm just going to wait until I get married again. I've said that now twice. This is my third time around. So I don't want to say that either. I'm not looking for perfection. What I'm looking for is, can you open your Bible with me and read with me, and can we pray together?
If he opens that Bible with you, he gonna mean what he said when he said, I'm not fucking you, let alone not being with you. You're already trying to say that you're a traditional Christian woman without even being a traditional Christian woman. You have 3 kids and you are divorced. Y'all want to always talk about faith, but then y'all be the main ones that be heavily outside y'all faith. All sorts of shit going on. But then y'all want to be over here like, oh, I'm practicing my faith now after I fucked up. See, God may forgive, but humans never forget.
That's it. That's all I'm saying.
Okay. You know, some of the cousins, they getting on you, girl.
You said what?
Some of the cousins in the comment section, they getting on you, girl. They calling you a lukewarm Christian.
No, I'm not a lukewarm Christian at all, but I'm not going to judge other people and just be like, and I'm not going to do that either, because there's also Christianity who just judges everybody. I'm not that person. I don't want to judge anybody, because you judge somebody, God's going to judge me the same way. I'm not lukewarm at all. I read my word. I pray regularly. I'm abstaining from sex today. And can I say in a year or 2 years that something won't happen? And the reason I'm saying that is because I've been there and I've done that, right?
AKA, she's a lukewarm Christian. She just literally said it, and she just said that she wasn't. Everything in the Bible teaches lessons. It's a lesson. You have to understand the lesson before you make the mistake. But I understand you're going to make those mistakes. But the thing about this is this. She's talking about she's going to be, she's, hold on, what that bullshit she said? Hold on.
God's going to judge me the same way. I'm not lukewarm at all. I read my word. I pray regularly. I'm abstaining from sex today. And
that part. So she reads her word. She prays every night. And she's abstaining from sex today. The problem is, you're saying you read your word and you pray every night, but you're not doing anything actively that's saying that you actually are practicing what you're reading. You're not practicing what you're reading. You're practicing because today you're trying to find somebody that's a wholesome man. But as you said before, November was the last time you had sex. I understand we all got our needs, but the thing is, you're trying to sit here and say that you're looking for somebody that's a Christian man, but those values are going to be very strong to a Christian man. That's what y'all don't understand. Y'all ask for something, but y'all don't understand what y'all asking for.
And can I say in a year or 2 years that something won't happen? And the reason I'm saying that is because I've been there and I've done that, right? So I can understand other people. And I'm not harping on Christianity. What I am harping on is I at least want a man to have the same faith that I do.
You are harping on Christianity because that's what you said. And you said it very clear a couple of times. Your non-negotiable was a man that's not walking as a Christian. So I was actually about to move on to something else, and then you had said it again. And that's when I was like, okay, well, maybe I need to deep dive to get clarity. So the clarity is this: for you, walking as a Christian means someone you can pray with and read the Bible with and believes in Jesus.
Correct.
Okay.
But notice something. She's not talking about practicing that faith, her faith with him. She's only bringing up the fact of praying and reading the Bible and going to church, but she's not talking about practicing faith. Faith without works is dead. And the problem with this is this. She's talking about reading the word of the Bible and reading and going to church but she's not talking about walking with God, or let me rephrase it. She's not talking about walking in her faith with God. She'll read her word and she'll pray, but she won't do the things that the Bible is teaching us. That's the one thing that a lot of these women don't want to actually have the conversation about.
All right. Should the guy look a certain way?
No. So the guys that I've dated, they all look differently. I'm attracted to what I'm attracted to. I've dated guys, though. I've tried to date guys. And if I'm just not attracted to you, there's nothing that you can do to, obtain attraction. Do I have a criteria for attraction? No, I don't.
You don't. Okay. What about money? Should he make a certain amount of money?
He needs to be able to support himself. That's my main thing. I don't have a dollar amount. I feel, I mean, I do okay. I'm not out here spending my money on trips and buying a whole bunch of extra extravagant things. And he doesn't need to either, but he does need to be able to sustain his lifestyle without me trying, without me having to add to it. I don't want to do that either.
Okay. Let's do the kids or Kim.
Okay. And I have on baggy clothes today, so, but I have on shorts up under my sweats.
Okay. All right. We see you. Okay, girlfriend. We see you, DL. Oh, DL.
Okay, so let me rewind this a little bit.
Let's do the kids or Kim.
Okay. And I have on baggy clothes today, so, but I have on shorts up under my sweats.
Mm-hmm. Walking as a Christian, y'all. This is what a modern Christian, woman is. Now, she looks like one of these Christians that, you want me to be completely honest? She looks like one of these Christians that act like they holy and endowed, but then be over there practicing all sorts of bullshit outside of church. Not even pleasant. Presentable, I mean. Not even presentable. But once a man that's a Christian man. She dressing like a hussy.
Okay, girlfriend. We see you, DL. Oh, DL, you're in Houston, right?
I am in Houston.
You want the guy to be in Houston?
I would prefer he be in Houston, yes.
And she has a tattoo on her hand. I'm pretty sure she's got tattoos in other places on her body. So she's not a traditional Christian woman. Hmm. Let's see this again.
You want the guy to be in Houston?
Two tattoos.
I would prefer he be in Houston.
What's that say?
Yes.
Okay. What's the age range you want to date? You're 43.
37 to 47. I'm flexible on that as well, though, but 37 to 47 is ideal.
And he can have kids already because you obviously don't want any more, you said, right?
Oh, yeah. I would prefer that he has children.
All right. What was your last relationship?
November 2022.
All right. You don't have to answer, but I'm going to ask. When's the last time you was intimate with someone?
November 2023.
Okay. Three flaws you have to work on.
I can be mean sometimes.
Not a Christian woman.
And it's not really, so that's one thing. And just because I can read through BS, I just don't have time for that. And I will call people out on their stuff.
Aggressive.
Maybe also being a little bit more patient with people in general. I probably need to do that.
Impatient.
And yeah, I don't know. I feel like I worked on a lot. I'm trying to think of something else. I'm really trying to find it.
Your presentation. There's one thing I can say about the other women that's come on this show. Even though a lot of them had a lot of problems, they still came on here presentable. Ma'am. You wouldn't like a traditional Christian man to be around you. You wouldn't. You're like one of these modern Christian men. But the traditional Christian men, the brothers that I know, they will call your shit out so fast that you will be crying. Let's finish this bullshit up before I get my full commentary on it.
But I can't find it right now.
You only got two flaws.
No, I'm saying I may have more than that. I'm sure I do. According to who you ask, I may have more. But that's the main thing that I hear is that I'm mean.
That you're mean?
Mean, yeah.
Okay, oh, we gotta work on that. Why would a guy be lucky to be with you?
I am extremely loyal. I'm compassionate. I have my head on straight. I can go from the boardroom to the ball to the hood. It doesn't matter. I'm flexible. I have a lot of great qualities. It's I just need someone who's very straightforward. Like, I can appreciate you telling me the truth versus you tell me the truth and it's going to hurt me versus you lying in my face, because that's going to bring out a different side of me.
Okay, so you heard that bullshit. Now, let me give my full commentary on this. On this woman. Ma'am, you are a lukewarm Christian that believes that she can be flexible. She's talking about she can be flexible between the hood, the ballroom, the boardroom, and executive. No, you cannot. Each woman is placed into a specific class, and there's a reason why. Because certain women carry certain traits that a lot of men value. Some women don't. Some women are inaccessible to the average men. And there's a very small percentage of women that are very inaccessible to the average man. And those are the ones that are the pay for play ones. The expensive escorts, I should say, the exclusive executive escort. Ma'am, you will be, in my honest opinion, you will be one of the ones that would be for the hood nigga. Or the average, or the below average man. I ain't gonna say the average man, the below average man. That's where you will fit in best. You want to sit here and say that you're this Christian woman, this Christian woman that's not a problem, or that's this holy and thou type of chick? No. You're not. You're the type of woman that a man's gonna just knock down and go somewhere else. You're not even practicing your faith correctly. So I'm sorry that this video isn't gonna be like my other videos, but I hate to see when these women be like, oh, I'm a Christian, but I have these problems. But anyways, guys, like, share, subscribe, channel, support the podcast, subscribe to the comments. See you guys on the flip side. Thank you guys for listening. I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.